Welcome to L'Église Marie-Reine, our sister parish located in Lester, Haiti. As you may know, Haiti is located just 700 miles from Florida. Once arriving in Port-au-Prince, it is a 3.5 hour drive to the community of Lester. Despite its close proximity, life in Haiti is quite different than life in the United States. In 2010, a 7.8 magnitude earthquake rocked the country of Haiti, and the church in Lester tumbled to the ground. Over the past 10 years, Père Christophe has been slowly rebuilding the church. There is a phrase commonly used in Haiti, "Petit petit oiseau fait niche," little by little the bird makes its nest. Row by row, the church is being built. In the meantime, Mass is celebrated outside in this simple structure. It is here in this humble place that bread and wine are transformed into the body and blood of Jesus Christ. Many people are involved at the parish. This group of women arrived one evening for choir practice, and these are some of the youth who volunteer as altar servers and lectors. The rectory was also damaged in the 2010 earthquake. The load-bearing walls are cracked at the ceiling, and the roof leaks in every room when it rains. Nonetheless, Père Christophe is happy to have a roof over his head. This is Marini, who comes every day to cook and clean. She prefers to prepare the meals outside where it is cooler, and then cooks inside where she is lucky to have a propane stove. Meals are served in this beautiful dining room full of hand-carved Haitian furniture. When he is finished with his meal, Père Christophe washes his own dishes. In his words, "I can't expect Marini to do everything." This is the room in which I stayed and the bathroom I used. There is no running water at the rectory, but thankfully the house has plumbing, so bucket flushing and bucket showering are available. Nothing feels better than a bucket full of cold water poured over your head after a full day spent in the Haitian sun. There is rarely electricity provided in Lester, and Père Christophe has only one small solar panel. He is thankful to have this 25-year-old generator, which he uses on Sundays to power the sound system for Mass. At the same time, he charges the few old batteries he has, which provide some power during the week so that he can charge his phone and use a light bulb at night. I met these two little girls while on a walk one afternoon. The one on the right had a few pieces of soggy cereal or crackers in the bottom of her bottle, which she kindly offered me. How very sweet of her! I declined, though. Père Christophe and I went to school one morning. The students line up by grade and begin their day in prayer. After prayer, they place their hands on their hearts and sing the national anthem. Physical touch is a beautiful part of Haitian culture and one of the many reasons I love Haiti. When people engage in conversation, they often stand hand in hand or with their arms draped over each other's shoulders. It is charming and heartwarming. I did not have time during my visit this past January to take pictures of each of the students, but that is one of my goals during my next visit. It is my hope that one day, every St. Francis de Sales household will have a picture of a child from our sister parish, a child for whom they will pray each and every day. We know that God hears our prayers, most especially when we pray for the least among us. Thank you for the many, many years of support you have provided for our sister parish, L'Église Marie-Reine, in Lester, Haiti. May God bless you.